The animated counter behavior is the next add-on that we'll be taking a look at. This add-on gives Construct 3 a new behavior, animated counter, that allows you to animate a text object with numbers, like a score. You can quickly animate a timer, score, anything you'd like with one behavior and one event. Check the description for a link to the Sierra store to get the animated counter add-on. This add-on works in both Construct 2 and Construct 3, but we'll be using it in Construct 3 today. Let's take a look at what it can do. I have a layout set up for us to test out this behavior. Right now, we've got several slimes that make their way across the layout. We've also got a text object, called score, in the upper right corner. When we click on the slimes, we'll destroy them and add to the score. I have this set up already, like you would do without the animated counter behavior and without any animation. I'll switch over to the event sheet and you can see how this works. There's a global variable containing the score value. When the player clicks the slime is destroyed, and we add a random amount between 1 and 500 to the score variable. Then we set the score text object to be equal to the score variable. When I preview the layout, I can click the slimes to kill them, and a random amount between 1 and 500 is added to the score. With the animated counter behavior, we can do this much faster, and we can animate the text so that it counts up to the final value, instead of jumping straight to it. Let's switch back to the layout and add the animated counter behavior to the score text object. Select the score object, select behaviors, and then add new behavior. Add the animated counter behavior to the object and close this down. The animated counter behavior has two properties that we can adjust, the animation time and the precision. Animation time is the time in seconds that it takes for the entire animation to complete. Precision lets you decide if you want the counter to increment in whole numbers or as a float with a decimal, and this number decides how many numbers will be seen after the decimal while the animation is active. The animation time is set to 2 currently, which is a little slow for what we're doing. I'll set it to 0.5, so it will take half a second for the animation to complete. Let's switch back to the event sheet and toggle the score setting actions from before. Then, I'll add a new action using the score text object. Right under angle, we've got three categories with actions for the animated counter behavior. The first two allow you to set the properties we just talked about, animation time and precision, in the event sheet instead of in the properties bar. Below that, we've got four actions used to set the value of the text object. We can add, subtract, set value, or set value, init, and target. Let's use add for now. We'll use a random value between 1 and 500. And we'll wrap it in floor so we get a whole number. I'll preview the layout. And now, when I click a slime, the score is updated with a random number, but the value increments. It doesn't just snap to the final value like it did before. And it takes half a second for the animation to complete. If I switch back to the layout, I have an altered version of the slime sprite in a second animation. I'll set the second slime to animation 2. Now, when you click this slime, I want the score to fall by 500 points. So, we need to check which animation is playing when the slime is clicked. I'll add a sub-event below the onObjectClicked event. And I'll choose the slime object. And select isPlaying. From here, I'll check if animation 1 is playing. Copy the event. And paste it. And then drag it under the other isPlaying event. Then, change the animation we're checking for to animation 2. Now, I'll drag the add action down into the animation 1 section, and add a new action under animation 2. Again, we'll use the score object, but this time, we'll subtract. I don't want a random number this time. I just want to penalize the player by 500 points. So we'll put in 500 and select Done. Now, when we click the pink slime, the value rises. But when we click the red slime, we're hit with a 500-point deduction from our score, and the text animates down to our new score. I'll toggle the subtract action so it's disabled. And we'll take a look at the other two options for setting a value. Set value is used to animate up or down to a specified amount, not add or subtract to the previous value. So if you set this to 1,000, when you click the red slime, the value will animate from its current value to 1,000. It won't add 1,000 to its current value, but it will animate directly to 1,000. If I preview the layout and click the red sprite, the score increments to 1,000. I'll reload the layout, and this time click a pink sprite first. We get a score of 464. Then click a red sprite, and our score goes up to 1,000. This can be useful for resetting a timer or anything that always resets to the same value. The other action is set value, init, and target. This is just like set value, except we can choose the starting value to increment or decrement from. So I'll set initial value to 200 and value to 1,000. Now when we click the red slime, the value is set directly to 200 and then increments up to 1,000. Below that, we have two more actions that we can use. These are both easy enough to understand. Stop stops the animation right where it is. I'll turn the animation time to 2 seconds so we have some time to see what happens. Then I'll set the score, when we click the pink slime, to 500. If I preview and click the pink slime, the score goes up to 500, and it takes 2 seconds for the animation to complete. I'll add another action using the system object and choose to wait for 1/2 a second. After that, we'll perform another action using the score object and we'll stop the animation. When I preview it, if I click the pink slime, the score begins animating to 500, but it will take 2 seconds to get there, and at 0.5 seconds in, the animation stopped and doesn't continue any further. The other action we have is force finish. This is just like stop, except instead of stopping at the value it's at when you call the action, it jumps to the final value, in this case 500. Let's take a look. I click a pink slime, and the score updates. Then it jumps to 500 after 1/2 a second. Last, we've got a few events that we can use associated with the animated counter behavior. Let's add a new event and check them out. Okay, we've got isAnimating, onAnimationStarted, and onAnimationFinished. isAnimating will be triggered when the animation is active. I'll select it and add an action using the light. The light is just a 2-frame sprite, one frame with a white circle, one with a green circle. We'll use the green circle to see when this event is working. I'll set its frame to 1. Then I'll add an else event and set the frame back to 0. So when the score is being animated, the light object will turn green, and else, when it is not animating, the light object will be set to white. When I click a slime, the score animates and the light turns green. After the animation has concluded, the light turns back to white. But this isn't necessarily the best way to do this. This animation is active over a series of frames. While the animation is active, for each of those frames, the light's frame will be continually set to frame 1, and every frame that the score is not animating, the light object is repeatedly being set to frame 0. This is a waste of resources. A better way to do this would be to use the other two events that the animated counter behavior provides. We'll replace the first event, is animating, with onAnimationStarted. This event fires off once, when the animation is started, not every frame, like isAnimating does. Then we can replace the else event with the onAnimationFinished event in the score object. onAnimationFinished fires off once at the end of the animation. If we preview the layout, it works just like it did before, but we've saved our CPU resources. All three of these events have their uses, so just use isAnimating when you need the event to repeat every frame. When you only need an event to fire at the start or end of an animation, use the onAnimationStarted or finished events. Thanks for watching. If you find this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon at patreon.com/todaystuts. For $1 a month, you can get early access to all new tutorials and help keep this channel active. See you next time.